Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends. I'm so glad you could attend. Come inside, come inside.
So a quick setup here, guys. Our party is traveling to the Pyramid of Shadows. I've done all sorts of homebrewed encounters leading up to the third module, 4E module in the series that Wizards of the Coast did. And I was all set to start the next encounter, and then Gabe, one of the co-pilers in our little group, he says, "Ben, we should make some floating rocks." And I said, "What am I going to do with floating rocks?" He goes, "Well, I want to make this piece on my 3D printer. I think we could come up with an encounter, and I think it'd be a lot of fun." And I said, "Well, okay, let's do it." So we do Terrain Saturdays like once a month, and so we started to sketch out what the encounter would look like. And Gabe kind of focused on making the rock terrain, and I started to figure out the mechanics. But one of the things that kind of set that up is, Gabe has a 3D printer, and we've been toying around with it, right? This is one of the things we kind of came up with. This is like one of the rocks that we made on the 3D printer. And Gabe wanted to take that to another level. And so I said, "Okay, no problem, we can do it." And so what he kind of came up with, I said, "Hey, I know how we can get these rocks to float. We can use some flying bases from Games Workshop, and you just have to create a piece to rest on those bases." And he said, "Oh, I can do that." So I think he kind of took a spin off of this piece right here. And I'll tell you guys, 3D printing is fascinating. We put a lot of stuff up on our Facebook page, bit.ly/FacebookRPG. And that's where I've been teasing you guys with a lot of the 3D stuff we've done so far. And that's just because we're so early on in the process. But that's kind of rock. This is one of Gabe's first prototype pieces. This is a cool little column he made. Isn't that something? It would blow your mind to see how this stuff is made. There's a video that shows it on our Facebook page. It's just layered one thing after another, and it just slowly builds it up. It's amazing. Yeah, here's another little prototype chest of something different we made. But so Gabe creates his piece. He paints it up. He's got a great little rock scheme that he uses. See, there's our base. A little big, I know, but whatever. It works. And you can really see the detail in there. Neat, huh? And then just to mix it up, Gabe made a two-figure one, a little bit wider. You can kind of see it, right? The player would be on this rock. And when the rock would kind of go up and down, and it would just kind of float in the air. But these give, then notice also we varied the heights, right? So that it would, I told him, "Hey, Gabe, cut those bases down a little bit and vary the height." So again, it feels more like it's floating kind of thing. And what we did was we made six of these. And each thing in the skill challenge that they do, as they get to, they have to, it's a 12 to 6 skill challenge. So every time they get two things right, they go from one rock to the next rock. We made six total rocks. That's how it kind of worked out. But it's pretty neat, huh, guys? One of the great things about 3D printing is it really brings home the, you can get all these great little divots and everything in there. And when you dry brush that, they just pop out. And Gabe threw a little flock on there too thing. But so those are Gabe's rocks. And you're going to see rock be a big theme in this encounter as we go. But we call the 3D printer that we have, we call it the Kraken. And every time we print a piece and we have the 3D model done, we like to say, "Release the Kraken," right? How could you resist? Classic Clash of Titans line. But there you go. And you certainly don't have to have a 3D printer, right? I wouldn't expect you guys to all have 3D printers and be making stuff. It's not easy, guys. It's quite the process. Gabe is a brilliant 3D modeler, and so that's why it works out pretty good for us. But there's another way you could do these. You could easily take foam, pink foam, and you could cut this down with a hot wire, and you could mount that on this base or on skewers or something like that, and it would work just as well. You've seen me paint terrain. This is a I use this in my caverns. There's some videos on this kind of stuff. But that easily could have been a rock. We could have put that on a base and it would have floated. And perfect. Mini Wargaming has an exceptional asteroid video that they do, which helped get me this idea. But so there's always ways. And if we wouldn't have had the 3D printer, we certainly would have just went with foam. So we have arcane floating rocks. We're going to have, the group's going to try to cross this cavern. So there's going to be rock here, there's going to be a rock over here, and they have to cross this distance, and they have to hop from floating rock to floating rock. So one of the things I needed some bluffs, and there's a company called Gale Force 9, exceptional quality guys. Everything those guys create is outstanding. They have a Battlefield in a Box series. And yes, you can certainly make your own rocks, but there come times where you don't want to make terrain, and you just want to you want something of high quality. You want to pull it right out of the box and use it. And Gale Force 9 is a great example of that. They have, this is their rocky outcroppings, this gray stuff here. They have a box of this, and it's very inexpensive, but it's all done. It's all flocked, painted beautifully. There's another one. I love these. Whenever I'm doing outdoor stuff or in a dungeon or cavern kind of thing, I'll pull these out. They have them in all different sizes. So that's the outcroppings. And then this is their, what's this called? It's like Badlands. This is their Badlands stuff. You see these small ones here. They have all sorts of sizes. And this is the Badlands pieces I have. And this is more of a brownish kind of thing. But those wouldn't really get it across. So I don't even know if I'm going to be able to get this all in camera, but we'll try. So then they have these huge ones. Yeah. Yeah, that'll get you enough of it. And so it's this big bluff. And one's a bluff, and this is the plateau. See, and your mini would be right at the top there.
Neat, huh?
So, obviously I would have it like this. I'm going to have, you know, one on one side, and I'm going to put one on the other side over here to do the gap. Sorry, I'm shaking a little bit here. But as you can see, ooh, look at that. And again, it's all done. It's painted perfectly. It's flocked perfectly. Tons of detail in it. You just pop it right out of the box and go. I could see fantasy Warhammer guys loving this. But so this is the bluff. Ew. And then here's the other one. This is the plateau. I'll drop it. There's the plateau. Look at those stairs, you guys. Try to get it all in picture. It's so big you can't get it in picture. See, and so that's going to be on the other side. So this is the side they're going to land on, nice and flat, and I'm going to be able to put some terrain on that side. But see, I'll have this on the other side like this, and then they would just be coming across. But isn't that beautiful? Very reasonably priced for what you get. So I think you just go to Gale Force 9's website. But those work perfect. I'm like, hey, now I got my gap. I'll put the plateau on one side, this bluff on the other side. I'll put my floating rocks in between. I got myself a nice open ravine that they got across. So this is a skill challenge that I'm doing, but one of the things I wanted to have in there is, I like when the group is harassed by something in the skill challenge. It gives them a sense of panic, urgency, that kind of thing. And so I posted on our Facebook page, I needed some monster suggestions, and good old Dungeon Master Mark, who has a great channel, and I highly recommend you subscribe to him, he's like, you know what you need? You need a rock. R-O-K. Look at that bad boy. Isn't he gorgeous? So he is going to be, they're going to see him, he's going to be doing dive bomber kind of drive-bys as they go. If a group rolls a 1, he might swing by for a claw attack. And he has a very high hit. If the group misses the skill by 12 or more, the same thing, he'll swing by for an attack. If they fail the skill challenge, they have to get across eventually. Or I got a module with no players in it, so they will eventually make it across. But if they take too long, they'll have to fight this. And I have this guy set up as an elite. So certainly there's great incentive for them to succeed. But I just love this miniature. That wingspan is great. The detail is fantastic. And again, floating rocks, a rock monster, come on. It writes itself. It's that good of an idea. One of the things I'm going to use to show flight with this guy, and you've seen me feature this before, this is that Dr. Wizards. I got the link on our blog for him, but he's got these flight stands, and basically it starts off looking like this. And you could, normally you could just be able to drop a mini on there to show flying, that kind of thing. But he's got these great add-ons, he calls them extenders, and you can put this on there. He's got them for all sizes, by the way. So see, then you put that on there, and now you're talking. Now the thing's up in the air like that. Perfect, right? So that works really good. He also has a circle, so you can even switch it like this. See, and then you can just rest that. You can just rest that on there, like so. So I'm going to use this to show flight on the game board. So that's the rock with my Wizards Emporium flight piece. So he can pick guys up and drop them. So I'm like, hey, I need a nest for this thing. So I'm going to use the Dwarven Forge nest. This was a limited edition piece that Stefan did a while ago. I can't remember what he released it with. But so I'm going to use this bad boy. This is going to be my big old nest. See that? Really painted. Like there's a rib cage in there. Some bones in there, weapons in there, the arrow right there. That's so neat. But I'm just going to set this up on a little piece of foam. And that's going to be my perch nest off to the side on the game board. And then if someone does get, if they do fight the rock, he'll be picking the guys up in his claws, and he drops them in this nest to eat. So here's a wide shot of the game board, and basically what I just want to show here is how I kind of set everything up, the rocks to show the gap in between, and how I might lay the rocks out to do the skill challenge. Again, it's the rocks themselves, distance to them doesn't matter because this is a skill challenge, so I don't have to be perfect in how I'm laying them out, but you kind of get a good feel here of, hey, they're in a big forest, they come across this ravine, they're going to go from one rock to the next. Big thing though, I'm only going to lay out a rock as they go. So even though I'm showing you all of them here on the board, it's just so you can kind of see how it all falls together, say when they get to the end of the skill challenge. But basically, the group is going to go on one rock. When they get to the first rock, it reveals the second rock. They get to the second rock, reveals the third rock, and so on. That's kind of how the game board's going to net out. Hope you enjoy that little one shot here. Hey, little mama, ain't gotta ask me if I want to. Tell me, can I get a light? Roll you up and let it run through my veins. 'Cause I can always see the farthest stars when I'm on you. But I don't wanna ever come down off this cloud of love, and you say, you got me hopped up on that bush of love. So high I'm on the ceiling, baby. So don't it be my dealer, baby. All I want is you, baby. One more time. Bush of love. So high I'm on the ceiling, baby. So don't it be my dealer, baby. All I want is you, baby. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Bush of love, girl. Ain't you? Ooh, 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 yeah. Hey, hey, just my little bush of love, girl. Now, hey, little mama, I love this highway on to. And I know that your sunlight won't run out anytime soon, yeah. You gave me a taste, now I know that there's no getting off you. Wanna ever come down off this cloud of love, and you say, 'cause now you got me high.
wrapped up on